Simon Smale. I'm a gastroenterologist in York, and welcome to More Than Just Medicine. I thought today I'd talk a bit about gastroesophageal reflux, which is a condition often characterised by a feeling of heartburn or acid refluxing from the stomach up into the gullet, where it causes burning pain and discomfort. That pain often radiates into the back between the shoulder blades. Sometimes it's associated with pain on swallowing, and people can sometimes also get acid at the back of the throat and a sensation of water coming or food coming back up to the back of the throat. Reflux is a common condition. It reflects physics, really. The pressure inside the chest, where the gullet sits, the swallowing tube, is on average negative, because otherwise when you breathe the air doesn't go in. And the pressure in the stomach is generally positive, because the stomach is within the abdomen, which is essentially a large cavity that contains lots of other organs. And at the lower end of the gullet, there is a ring of muscle that stops the reflux of acid and the food that we've eaten from the stomach back up into the gullet. That ring of muscle has a relatively low pressure, it's a low pressure sphincter, and when the pressure in the stomach goes up at all, we're prone to getting acid refluxing up into the gullet. So then that leads to the question of, is this condition related to too much acid? Well, very occasionally it is, under certain very special and unusual circumstances, but more commonly it relates to the physics of having a high gastric pressure or a low sphincter pressure, so or poor emptying of the esophagus due to a condition that leads to problems with the motility of the gullet. But most commonly it's around things that affect the emptying of the stomach and the tone of the sphincter at the lower end of the gullet. Now, what are those things? Well, first of all, things that increase the pressure in the stomach include pregnancy. Weight gain is the commonest factor. If you're overweight, you're much, much more likely to reflux than someone who isn't overweight, who's got a BMI of, say, 22 as compared to 27 or 28. I know for myself, when I'm 14 stone 2, I get reflux. When I'm 13 stone 2, I don't get reflux at all and I can eat what I like. The trouble is then I tend to quickly reach a weight of 14 stone 2 and I get reflux every day. Other things that increase the pressure in the stomach, obviously eating large meals and eating fatty meals, because fatty meals delay the emptying of the stomach, and so there's more food and more acid in your stomach for longer. So those are the things that tend to increase pressure in the stomach, leading to reflux up into the gullet. Obviously there are other less common things like ulcers at the lower end of the stomach or in the duodenum that can actually obstruct the outlet, but that doesn't cause reflux as a primary problem but more as a secondary problem. Then there are drugs and other things that we ingest all the time that can decrease the tightness of the ring of muscle at the lower end of the gullet that's meant to stop us refluxing. That would include alcohol, which, as many people will be aware, if they go out for a night on the town or if they have a glass of wine too many, they'll be aware that they may be prone to reflux, particularly if that's washed down with a large meal late at night, as is sometimes the case for people. And similarly, caffeine can decrease the tightness of that ring of muscle at the lower end of the gullet, thus making us more prone to reflux. Now, I'm often asked whether exercise is a good thing. Well, exercise is clearly a good thing if it's helping us to control our weight. But actually during exercise, because we're increasing the tone of the muscles in the stomach, many of us, when we're doing cardiovascular exercise, that increases the pressure in the stomach, so it's more likely to reflux. But per se, there are ways around that, and I'm sure other colleagues would advise on what exercises are best in that regard. Similarly, bending down in the garden and doing the weeding is another thing which often causes people to reflux. and then, not surprisingly, laying flat at night sometimes causes reflux. Although actually, people tend to only get reflux during periods of arousal at night rather than when they're actually in deep sleep. So those are some of the things in terms of lifestyle that can make reflux worse. Weight, caffeine, alcohol, and they're all avoidable. With a little self-discipline, perhaps, although I wouldn't even... the most disciplined of us obviously has periods when we're struggling to control our appetites. So, thanks for listening. I hope that's given you some more information about reflux. I'll talk on another occasion, perhaps, about hiatus hernia and some of the sequelae of reflux. I hope that's been informative.